So Srila Parikshit Maharaj, he heard from Shukadeva Goswami the pastimes of deliverance of Putana. And the last verse, when Shukadeva Goswami glorified the pastimes of Lord Krishna, and he said that ya etat putana moksham krishnasya arbhakam adbhutam shunyach shaddayo martyo govinda labhate ratan. He made a point in this. He said, any person who hears with faith and devotion about how Krishna, the Supreme Lord, killed Putana, and how and who thus invests his hearing in such childhood pastimes of Krishna, what does he get? He gets that his mind fixed up in Lord Govinda. Here, Shukadeva Goswami says, Krishnasya arbhakam adbhutam. So Shukadeva Goswami is using the word adabhutam, means wonderful, specifically very wonderful. Now, that this incident of Putana, which was covered in the last chapter, in which the Supreme Lord killed Putana, she came to kill Krishna, but she herself got killed. We can see in this pastimes how Krishna is very merciful, how Krishna has been very kind. Otherwise, if someone comes to kill you, will you give him a position in your room, in your house, in your life? No. But somebody is coming to kill Krishna, and Krishna in return is giving her a position of a mother in the spiritual world. she was not a devotee. She was a demon. Putana was a demon. But she came disguised as a devotee. And still Krishna gave her a position of a mother. So by which we can understand that this pastimes actually exhibits the mercy of Lord Krishna. And also we can come to know that Krishna doesn't see the dark side of a person. He only saw that she came to Braj. She came to Vrindavan. And she came disguised as a gopi. And she wanted to feed me breast milk. So these are all, and she was wearing a dress of Mother Yashoda. So Krishna, seeing her external appearance and being very kind to her, being very merciful to her, and without seeing her dark side, Krishna delivered her, killed her, purified her, and then gave her a position of a mother in the spiritual world. So Krishna has left us many wonderful narrations about him in Srimad Bhagavatam. So simply by hearing these narrations which are described in Srimad Bhagavatam, what happens? One gains salvation from this material world and gradually develops attachment for Lord Govinda. That's our goal, to develop attachment. Govinda labhate ratim. Always remember Krishna, never forget Krishna. So we want to fix our mind in Krishna. So Shukadeva Goswami is saying that hearing the pastimes of Lord Krishna, what happens? Govinda labhate ratim. Our mind becomes fixed in Krishna. So Maharaj Parikshit, when he heard these pastimes of deliverance of Putana, he became very pleased and satisfied in his heart, and he said to Shukadeva Goswami. What did he say? He said, Ena ena avatarena bhagavan haririshvara karoti karna ramyani manogyani chana prabho. So Parikshit Maharaj is saying, Ena ena avatarena bhagavan haririshvara. Oh, my dear Shukadeva Goswami, my dear Gurudev, that you have narrated to me so many different wonderful pastimes from various incarnations. And how are these pastimes? Karana Ramyani. He is saying that these pastimes are very pleasing to the ears. When we hear Krishna Katha, we get a kind of satisfaction. Karana Ramyani. And then what happens? Parikshit Maharaj is saying not only Karana Ramyani but Manah Jnani. It has been very attractive to the mind. And then he further says that anyone who simply hears these narrations, what happens? Yad shunvanta apiti. Apiti means vanishes. What vanishes? Aratihi, unattractiveness. If we have no attraction for Krishna, so if we hear such pastimes of the Lord again and again, we will develop attraction for Krishna. So, what vanishes after hearing such pastimes? Aratihi. Aratihi will be converted to ratihi. So, and then what he says further? With Trishna, the dirty things within the mind that makes us uninterested in Krishna consciousness, that goes away. And further, Maharaj Parikshit says, Sattvam ta shuddye arichena pumsam. And what more vanishes? One attachments for hearing about material things. Now, hearing about the material things is the root cause of material existence. We have desire to hear about material world. That's why our material existence continues. When we desire to hear about Krishna, then we will develop attraction for Krishna and then we will attain Krishna. And what happens? Once attachment for hearing about material things goes away, and bhaktir harau tad purushai cha sakhyam. One gradually develops devotional service to the Supreme Lord. One gradually develops attachment towards him and friendship with his devotees. So everything happens by hearing. So hearing is the base. Hearing Navida Bhakti, hearing is the first, kept as first thing. Why? Because hearing is the base.